Good morning, children. In previous classes, we have studied SAS congruency rule, ASA congruency rule, SSS congruency rule, also RHS congruency rule. These four congruency rules we have learned in previous classes. Also, we done some examples. Also, we done some problems which are given in exercises. Also, we have done. After that, we have learned in a triangle, the sides opposite to equal angles are equal. We have learned this. The sides opposite to equal angles are equal. Also, we learned the angles opposite to the equal sides are also equal. We learned this in second exercise in this chapter, triangles. Second exercise, we have learned these two points. The angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Also, we learned the sides opposite to equal angles are also equal. From these two theorems, we have to think if in a triangle, two sides are unequal. Here, two sides are equal, then the angles opposite to the equal sides are equal. Right? In this theorem. If in a triangle, two sides are unequal, what is the nature of the angles opposite to that unequal sides? See here. If two sides of a triangle are equal, the angles opposite to the equal sides are equal. We have learned already. We done some problems also. Today we have to discuss about in a triangle, if two sides are unequal, what is the nature of angles? If two sides are unequal, what is the nature of angles opposite to that unequal sides? Also, we have to learn if in a triangle, if two angles are unequal, what is the nature of sides opposite to that unequal angles? Let us now study about with some examples. See here. Here we have a right angle triangle here. This is, in this triangle, this is a right angle, and these two are acute angles. See here once this triangle. For example, in these three angles, this angle is right angle and this angle is acute angle. These two are unequal angles because this is right angle and this is an acute angle. Observe once here, the side opposite to right angle, see here, is longer than the side opposite to the right angle is longer than the side opposite to the side opposite to acute angle. Correct or not? Right? The side opposite to right angle is longer than the side opposite to acute angle. Is this correct or not? Correct. Now see here, this is another right angle triangle. See here. Here these two angles are equal. These two angles are equal. So these two sides are equal. Right? Now this is right angle. These two angles are equal and this is right angle. That means this angle and this angle, these two angles are unequal. Because this is an acute angle and this is a right angle. See, observe here. The side opposite to right angle is longer than the side opposite to acute angle. See once. Is it right? Correct. Also, see here, we have draw a line segment here. Here we drawn a line segment, for example, XY. Right? Line segment XY here. Also, we have draw with some length from the radius from the center X. See here, I have drawn an arc here. Identify some points here, A, B, C, and D, and E, and F. Observe here, see here, now see here join AY, here triangle XAY, here is the angle X. If this angle increases here, the side is also increasing, correct or not? If the angle is increased more, the side also changing, right? So from this example, we clearly know if the angle is increased, the side opposite to the largest angle is longer. See here, the length is increasing. See, from the above examples, we have concluded three statements here. That means three theorems here. See here, if two sides of a triangle are unequal, the angle opposite to the longer side is larger. See here, two sides of a triangle are unequal. If equal, the sides opposite to the equal angles are equal. If two sides of a triangle are unequal, the angle opposite to the longer side is larger. If two sides of a triangle are unequal, the angle opposite to the longer side is larger. The angle opposite to the longer side is larger. We have concluded this statement with the help of some examples. We have proof also, but not required here. See, theorem 7.7. In any triangle, the side opposite to larger angle is longer. Converse of the above statement. See here, in any triangle, if two angles are unequal, the side opposite to the larger angle is longer. The side opposite to the larger angle is longer. The side opposite to the larger angle is longer. See another statement here, theorem 7.8. We learned this statement in 7th class also. What is here? The sum of any two sides of a triangle, is always greater than the third side. We learned this statement in 7th class also. See here, what is the statement here? The sum of any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. See, from these three statements, we are going to do some problems using these three statements, these three theorems. we are going to do some problems which are given in exercise. See here, exercise 7.4, first question. See here, what is given in the question here, what is given in the problem here? Show that in a right angle triangle, the hypotenuse is the longest side. Show that in a right angle triangle, the hypotenuse is the longest side. So, before going to solve this statement, we have to draw a triangle here, right angle triangle here, because given it is a right angle triangle. For example, here I have to take triangle XYZ is a right angle triangle and a right angle at Y, right? What is given here? In triangle XYZ, in triangle XYZ, angle Y equal to 90 degrees. That means this angle is right angle. What we have required to prove here? We have required to prove is what is the hypotenuse here? XZ. XZ is greater than YZ. Also, XZ is greater than XY. This is required to prove here. Solution. In triangle XYZ, angle X plus angle Y plus angle Z equal to, the sum of angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. Therefore, sum of angles is 180 degrees and we already know angle Y is 90 degrees. So, angle X plus angle Z equal to 90 degrees. Since angle Y equal to 90. Since angle X plus angle Z equal to 90, angle X is less than angle Y and angle X is less than angle Z. Angle X is less than angle Y and also angle Z is less than angle Y. Angle Z is also less than angle Y, right? From these two statements we have, that means angle X is less than angle Y. See here, angle X is less than angle Y. That means angle Y is larger than angle X. Therefore, the side opposite to the larger angle is longer. We already know. Since the side opposite to larger angle is longer, XZ is greater than, what is the angle, what is the side opposite to the angle X? YZ. So, XZ is greater than YZ. So, one is proved here. Next, we have to prove second one also. See here, second one, since angle Z is less than angle Y, angle Z is less than angle Y, here is angle Z and here is angle Y. That means angle Y is greater than angle Z. So this is the largest angle. Because since this is the largest angle, the side opposite to the largest angle is longer. XZ is greater than, what is the side? XY. The side opposite to angle Z is XY. Therefore, XZ is greater than XY. From these two statements we have, that is XZ is greater than XY and xz is greater than yz. From the above, we have to say in a right angle triangle, the hypotenuse is the longest side. Therefore, in a right angle triangle, the hypotenuse is the longest side. The hypotenuse is the longest side. Longest side. Hence we have proved. Read once. What is given question? In adjacent figure, sides AB and AC of triangle ABC are extended to points P and Q respectively. Also, given that angle PBC is less than angle QCB, then show that AC is greater than AB. What is angle PBC here? This is angle PBC and this is angle QCB. What is given here? PBC is less than QCB. See figure once. We have to show AC is greater than AB. AC is greater than AB. See here. The angle at B. What is the sum of these two angles? The sum of these two angles is 180 degrees. Because these two angles are linear pair. So, from the figure, we know angle PBC plus angle ABC equal to 180 degrees. Since these two angles are linear pair. Also see here, these two angles also 180 degrees. So, angle QCB plus angle ACB equal to 180 degrees. Since these two angles are equal to 180 degrees, the LHS is also equal. That means, angle PBC plus angle ABC equal to angle QCB plus angle ACB. See here, in this equality, we have angle PCB is less than angle QCB. Angle PBC is less than angle QCB. See here, angle PBC and angle QCB here. Since PBC is smaller than QCB, ABC is greater than ACB. From the above, we have angle ABC is greater than angle ACB. Since angle PBC is less than angle QCB. Right? So, angle ABC is greater than ACB. We learned a theorem, a statement in previous section. What do we have learned here? The side opposite to greater angle is longer. The side opposite to the larger angle is longer. That means, here angle B is longer, larger than angle C. Therefore, the side opposite to angle B is longer than the side opposite to angle C. That means AC is greater than AB. Since the side opposite to larger angle is longer. Hence, we have proved AC is greater than AB. See, What is given in question number 3? Read the question once. In the absent figure, angle B is less than angle A and angle C is less than angle D. Then show that AD is less than BC. See here, what is given? Angle B is less than angle A. Angle B is less than angle A is given here. Right? Angle B is less than angle A is given here. See, in triangle AOB, in triangle AOB, angle B is less than angle A. Angle B is less than angle A. That means angle A is greater than angle B. Angle A is greater than angle B. Since angle A is greater than angle B, BO is greater than AO. Since angle A is greater than angle B, BO is greater than AO. From our theorem 7.6, what we have learned there? The side opposite to the largest angle is larger, longer. Right? What is the theorem here? The side opposite to the largest angle is longer. That means BO is greater than AO. BO is greater than AO. Since the side opposite to largest angle is longer. Therefore, since angle A is greater than angle B, BO is greater than AO. Let it as number 1. See here is another triangle COD. In triangle COD, we have angle C is less than angle D. Angle C is less than angle D. That means angle D is greater than angle C. Angle C is less than angle D means D is the largest angle than angle C. So since D is the largest angle, the side CO is longer than side DO. Therefore, CO is greater than DO. CO is greater than DO. Since same above reason, the side opposite to largest angle is longer. See here, let it as 2. From 1 and 2, we have, see here, this is 1. What is 1 here? BO is greater than AO. From 2, CO is greater than DO. Since these two are greater than AO and DO, the sum of these two, BO and CO, that means, from 1 and 2, BO plus CO, these two are greater than these two. So BO plus CO is greater than AO plus DO. BO plus CO means BC is greater than AO plus OD means AD. Therefore BC is greater than AD. That means AD is less than BC. AD is less than BC. Hence proved. See here, question number 4, exercise 7.4. What is given in that problem here? See, AB and CD are respectively the smallest and longest sides of a quadrilateral ABCD. What is the smallest side here? AB is the smallest side and CD is the longest side of quadrilateral. ABCD is given. Given that in quadrilateral ABCD, in quadrilateral ABCD, AB is the smallest side, AB is the smallest side and CD is the longest side, CD is the longest side. This is given. What we have required to prove here? Required to prove is, first one, angle A is greater than angle C, and second one is angle B is greater than angle D. Right, we have required to prove this one, angle A is greater than angle C and angle B is greater than angle D. For that, solution, join AC, join A and C. If you join what says A and C, see here we get two triangles. If we join A and C, we get two triangles. The triangles are triangle ABC and triangle AC. Two triangles are here. In these two triangles, see here, the side AB is the smallest side in quadrilateral ABC. Since AB side is smallest, AB is less than BC. That means BC is greater than AB. Right? In quadrilateral ABCD, AB is the smallest side. We have given here, AB is the smallest side. Since AB is the smallest side, BC is the longest side in triangle ABC. BC is greater than AB. The length of BC is greater than the length of AB. Right? Join AC in triangle ABC. We have side BC is greater than side AB. Side BC is greater than side AB. Since AB is the smallest side in quadrilateral ABCD. AB is the smallest side in quadrilateral ABCD. BC is greater than AB. BC is greater than AB. That means the angle at A is greater than angle at C. See here, angle at A means angle BAC is greater than angle ACB. Angle ACB. Let it as 1. Why angle BAC is greater than angle ACB? Since angle opposite to longest side, angle opposite to longest side is larger. Therefore, since BC is the longest side, angle BAC is greater than angle ACB. Next, in triangle ACD, we have CD is the longest side. So, CD is greater than AD. Since in triangle ABCD, CD is the longest side, CD is greater than AD. Since CD is the longest side in quadrilateral ABCD. CD is the longest side in quadrilateral ABCD. CD is greater than AD. Since CD is greater than AD, CD is greater than AD, the angle opposite to the longest side is larger. So that angle DAC, angle DAC is greater than angle DCA. Angle DCA. Let it as 2. By adding 1 and 2, we have angle BAC plus angle DAC is greater than angle ACB plus angle DCA. See here, we have to add these two. Angle BAC plus angle DAC is greater than angle ACB plus angle DCA. Since these two are greater than these two, the sum of these two are always greater than these two. Therefore, what is angle BAC plus angle DAC? Angle A in quadrilateral ABC. Therefore, angle A is greater than. What is angle ACB plus angle DCA? Angle C in quadrilateral ABC. Therefore, angle A is greater than angle C in quadrilateral ABCD. Therefore, angle A is greater than angle C in quadrilateral ABCD. Right? We have proved first bit. Now, we are going to prove second bit in this question. See, we have to prove second bit. Solution: join BD. Join BD. See here, this is quadrilateral ABCD, which is given in the question. So now we have to prove angle B is greater than angle D. For that, we have to join B and D. Join B and D. Here we have two triangles, C1s, triangle ABD and triangle BCD. In triangle ABD, we have AB is the smallest side in quadrilateral ABCD. Since AB is the smallest side in quadrilateral ABCD, we have AD is greater than AB. AD is greater than AB. AD is greater than AB. Since AB is the smallest side in quadrilateral ABCD, we have AD is greater than AB. Since AD is greater than AB, the angle at B is greater than the angle at D. Right? AD is greater than AB. Since the angle opposite to longest side is larger. That means angle ABD is greater than angle ADB. Angle ADB. Let it as 1. Right. We have another triangle here. Triangle BCD. In triangle BCD, C1's given that CD is the longest side. Since CD is the longest side, the angle opposite to CD is larger than angle. See here, what is the angle opposite to CD in triangle BCD? CD is greater than CD is greater than BC. Since CD is the longest side, CD is the longest side in quadrilateral ABC. Right? CD is the longest side in quadrilateral ABCD. We have angle CBD. Angle CBD is greater than, because the angle opposite to the longest side is larger. Therefore, angle CBD is greater than. What is the angle opposite to BC? Angle BDC. Angle CD. Angle CD. Let it as 2. If you add these two, 1 and 2, angle ABD plus angle CBD is greater than angle ADB plus angle CD. See here, what is angle ABD plus CBD? Angle B in quadrilateral ABC. So angle B is greater than. What is angle ADB and angle CDB? Angle D in quadrilateral ABC. Therefore, angle B is greater than angle D in quadrilateral ABC. From this, we have proved both the angle A is greater than angle C and angle B is greater than angle D. We have tried to solve some questions which are related to the third theorem. What is the third theorem here? The sum of any two sides in a triangle is always greater than the third side. Right? See here, what is the question number 6 given here? If two sides of a triangle measures 4 cm and 6 cm, find all possible measurements of the third side. The measurement must be a positive integer. Find all possible measurements of the third side, and the measurement must be a positive integer. How many distinct triangles can be obtained? See here, question 1. Two sides are given, 4 cm and 6 cm. Find all the possible measurements of the third side. What is the condition we already learned? What is the condition here? The sum of any two sides of a triangle, any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. Greater than the third side. This is the condition we learned. Right? From this, let the third side be X. Let the third side be X. See here, if it is x centimeters, x plus 4 is greater than 6. Is it correct or not? See, the sum of any two sides is greater than the third side, right? So let the third side be x centimeters. So x plus 4 is greater than 6. When it is possible, x plus 4 is greater than 6, when it is possible? If x is greater than 2, it is possible. So x is greater than 2. Also, see here, other two, 6 plus 4 these two sides, 6 plus 4 is greater than x. Why 6 plus 4 is greater than x? The sum of any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. Therefore, 10 is greater than x. That means x is less than 10. X is less than 10. So x is greater than 2 and x is less than 10. What are the positive integers between these two statements? X is greater than 2 and x is less than 10. So what is the possible positive integers here? That means x equal to 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 or 9. So how many possible measurements? How many total? 7 measurements are possible. Total 7 measurements are possible. So how many distinct triangles can be formed? 7 distinct triangles can be formed. 7 distinct triangles. Distinct triangles can be formed. See here. See once question number 7. Try to construct a triangle 5 centimeters, 8 centimeters, and 1 centimeter. Is it possible or not? The given measurements are 5 centimeters, 8 centimeters, and 1 centimeter. Is it possible or not? Why? Give me your justification. See here. We already learned a theorem here. The sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. See here, if we add these two sides of 5 centimeters and 1 centimeter, what is the sum here? 5 plus 1 is 6. Since 5 plus 1 equal to 6 is less than the third side, 8 centimeters. See here, 5 plus 1 is 6. This is less than the third side. What is the theorem here? The sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. But here, less than the third side. Therefore, in this, with these measurements, the construction of triangle is not possible with these measurements. So, it is not possible for construct a triangle. Construct a triangle with these measurements. With these measurements. See children, from this problem, we have completed the chapter triangles. See, in the chapter, we learned SAS congruency rule, ASA congruency rule, SSS congruency rule, and RHS congruency. All four congruency rules we have learned. Also, we learned two more theorems. The theorems are, the sides opposite to the equal angles are equal. The angles opposite to the equal sides are equal. Also, we have learned some inequalities in a triangle. Here we learned three theorems. The three theorems are, the side opposite to the largest angle is longer. The angle opposite to the largest, the angle opposite to the longest side is larger. Also we learned the sum of any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. See, we have done some problems. Also, some problems are left over also. The problems which are left over, you have tried to solve the problems with the help of your teacher. So, thank you, Vananda.